Great to be here. My first time in Barcelona, first time in Spain. So thank you for the invitation. I appreciate it greatly. My name is Roy Rubin. I'm the founder and CEO of Varian, the Magento company. In today's session, the next 30 minutes or so, I'm going to be talking about selecting the right e-commerce platform. Process that's often very difficult and very overwhelming for a lot of online retailers. And we'll try to just highlight some points and make that process a little bit easier for the audience here. Before I do that, I'll talk a little bit about who I am and the company that I represent. I founded Varian in 2001. We are an open source e-commerce consulting firm. That's what we did for the first few years of our existence. In 2007, we started working on a project called Magento, which, how many of you have heard of Magento, just out of curiosity? Okay, so there's a few people here. That's great to hear. Founded Magento in 2007 with a production version coming out at the beginning of 2008. The platform today is the fastest growing e-commerce platform in the market, close to 500,000 downloads. We have a partner list of about 90 plus worldwide partners out of over 1,500 companies that have expressed interest to join what we're doing. So we're very excited to see the traction. There's some additional numbers here if you're interested. And we're, you know, as I said, very excited to see the traction, especially in the Spanish market. It's good news for us. The product also recently won two big awards. We won the InfoWorld's Bossy Award for the best enterprise open source e-commerce platform, as well as the SourceForge.net Award for best new open source project of the year. All right, we'll get back to our topic. The right solution. So that's something that comes up very often. And when we talk to a lot of retailers, and we spend a lot, a lot of our time, a great deal of our resources in talking to online retailers, understanding what their needs are, what their specifications are for the project. Everybody is trying to find the right platform, the perfect platform. The reality is that there is no perfect platform. You're not going to find a product that has every single feature and every single business objective out of the box. It just isn't feasible. And much like this picture shows, you really can't fit a square peg in a circle, in a round hole. So what you can do is, first of all, realize that you're not going to be finding the right or the perfect platform. Is actually a better choice of words, the perfect platform. What you want to find is a platform that you can build on, a platform that you can extend, a platform that can serve your business not only for the short term, for the next 6 to 12 to 18 months, but also for the long term. So think ahead, think years ahead, in fact, and find a product that you can work with and expand on for years to come. The most important thing is that the product satisfies your primary business objectives. And if conversions is something that's critical to you, as it is critical to a lot of online businesses, in fact, it's probably the most critical thing, then concentrate on a product that does that incredibly well. We'll see in a few minutes how bloat can happen, and looking for a product that does everything can really sort of steer you from the target. So my recommendation to a lot of online retailers is to look for a product that satisfies your primary business objectives. So getting started. So what we often recommend is to do an internal business evaluation. In many cases, when you decide on a new platform, you're in one of two different positions in the business. You're either doing what we call a replatforming project. So you have a current platform that you're using, and you're looking to move on to a different platform. That's a replatforming project. Or you're starting new, and you're looking for a product that will launch your online business. So the first thing is, if you're doing a replatform, take a look at the internal business processes. And make sure that those processes are in fact solid. This is a great opportunity to take a step back, see if you need to work on your customer service, on your order process, on your shipping process, on your catalog, on your merchandising, on your sales. That's all very important to take a look at. Start new. Think about what you would like to have when really starting at this process. But look deep internally at that process. The next thing is the competitive landscape evaluation. So there's really two elements in that. You certainly want to take a look, and that's common knowledge. Take a look at your competitors, see what they're doing, and make sure that you can certainly compete when this project is over. But not only that, you want to take a look at also other types of sites and competitors that reach your audience. So they're not direct competitors, but they're businesses that are catering to the same audience that you're trying to cater to. For example, look at how Facebook does its marketing, right? A lot of viral marketing. Understand how that works. See if you can apply that to your business. If you're marketing to the demographics, you know, the Facebook demographic, if you will, there's a lot to learn from Facebook and how they do business, how they speak to that audience, and you can internalize that and understand better how to target those audiences. So again, look at two different things: your direct competitors, your indirect competitors, but at the same at the end of the day, they're all targeting the same audience which you're trying to target. Talk to your customers. Make sure that you understand very clearly what they want. Involve them in the process. Ask them and survey them. Ask them what they want to see, what is missing in the website, what you can improve on. The more you can involve the customer and make them a part of this process, the more engaged they'll be. They'll talk about your project, and they'll feel a sense of ownership, which is very important when you're trying to maintain the customers. I can give you an example. Zappos.com, a $1 billion online retailer in the United States. Zappos.com, Zappos.com. Very successful company. In fact, it's often referred to as one of the benchmarks in the e-commerce market in the United States. And they have a beta website called Zeta.Zappos.com, Zeta.Zappos.com. And they've been running with their beta product, in a sense, to get feedback from the customers before they even launch the product. So they're running these two parallel websites, collecting feedback, getting a lot of the market input before they're making this transition. And they have an incredibly loyal customer base, and they're involving them in the process. I think this is a very new way of looking at it, and they've done so very successfully. Network with colleagues, and that really goes hand in hand with the next step of learning industry trends. So we're all very consumed in our day-to-day work. We're all busy. You know, we try to get out to conferences and kind of hear what's going on in the market. But the reality is that you really have to do some outreach and look outside your organization to get some ideas and really internalize that and bring that back into the organization. Take a step back. Again, look at what's in the market. Look at what's coming up. Really use this time of the replatforming or the starting new to see what is available for you to do. And you're looking at a long-term project, guys. This is a major investment, and you want to make sure that you're as up to date on what's going on and what's coming up as possible.